Aldi in Loughborough is literally only 200 yards from the canal. Wish I'd known actually, because I've just walked 15 minutes to it. Sleeper carriage, it's got a sleeper on the side of it. Well, coming into Loughborough, and on the right here is new apartments, but originally that had to be either a warehouse or a factory of some description. It's called the mill, so I guess that was a factory. This section of the towpath has been recently upgraded. It's all very, very smart. The overwhelming thing with the stretch of canal after Leicester up to, we're on our way to Nottingham, up to Nottingham, is how quiet it is. We've met very few boats, very, very quiet. I don't know if it's the economic climate at the moment, or because the weather's been cold in this part of the world, because it is still cold. Even though they're enjoying marvellous sunshine in the west of the country. Anyway, from the Nottingham Road Bridge, number 38, if you're looking for inexpensive groceries, there's an Aldi that you can moor up. Literally only 200 yards across the road. Go on under the Nottingham Road Bridge. Keep on going underneath the next bridge, which is where the boat inn is on the canal side, which all looks very nicely appointed. Sure, on a sunny day that's absolutely packed with customers. Carry on going up the canal past the residential area. As I say, the towpath's all been nicely upgraded here, it's very smart. Playtime at the school. Past the weeping willow on your left hand side, and then over on the right hand side, if you peer through the bushes and trees, you'll see a big B&Q, so you can moor up anywhere on the right hand side up here on the grass verge, and literally 200 yards across that road is the Aldi supermarket. So it saves you carrying groceries a long way, and it also saves you a little bit of dosh. bit of a right hand turn there. Let's hope I've gone the right way.
Yeah, let's hope.
Number 40, the bridge. Coming up for a lock. Thank you. I want to ditch some rubbish anyway.
Okay.
But thanks for your help.
Not a bit. Well, goes around, comes around.
Yes. St. James's Church, Normanton on Soar. Very pretty sight coming around the bend there. Boating club, private moorings. That's an emergency mooring spot for when the river goes into flood. And it's built at high levels so that the boat doesn't end up in the field when the water goes down. Fancy being here when the river's in flood. So the water's tumbling over this weir, even though the river is quite benign at the moment. God knows what that must be like when it's in flood. It must be horrendous. And we're just about to go through the floodgate that they close when it's in flood. Better slow right down, it's on a tight bend, don't know if there's anything coming the other way. Zouch Road Bridge with the floodgates. Just coming up to the Otter Pub. Houseboats with bay windows. Novel, isn't it? Right, this is Kegworth New Lock, and there is a sign there saying risk of seal hang-ups in the lock, and I'll show you why. This is a very big, deep lock, and the seal is the biggest one I've ever seen on a lock. That must be a 6 foot difference between the lock gates where they sit on the sill and the bottom of the lock. I can see you need to be really vigilant here, otherwise you could easily have a disaster on your hands. So here we go. Actually, that we're having to fill an empty lock and the boat's not in there, being the other way around. So that's the view from the other end of the lock. You kind of get an idea of how far down the river level is. Like Kew Gardens on those lock gates. It's pretty leaky too. So once the water reaches the level where the sluice gates are, it doesn't look so fierce. But there's already a serious amount of water come into this lock and it's still got a long way to go. nice bit of foam on top of the water there. So that was a seriously deep and large lock. Glad I'm through it. And the gates were really heavy to move. And the paddles were really heavy to move as well. Well, bye bye Kegworth Lock. You've been an experience. What is it the sunscreen man says? Do one thing that scares you every day. Well, I think I've done mine for the day.